Okay, now I will show you how to execute the menu config to open the configuration in the program. I will also describe you what the coreboot menu config consists of and what can be configured in each of these main categories. As I will be going through the menu config, I will explain all these options. Okay, so let's execute make menu config, and it will display the configuration menu, which is used to set up our coreboot build, and starting from general setup. So here we can see some basic settings for compiler and other secondary parsers, compiler stuff, some CMOS option tables, compression settings, whether to include the .config file into the final ROM image, some blobs configuration, address sanitizer and stuff. You can also add a boot splash image here or set where the code should be stashed, for example, for the resume from memory. Also, you can set a local version string here, which will finally appear in the SM BIOS, for example, type 0 in the BIOS string version and stuff. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is a mainboard. Here is probably the most often used and most useful submenu, because it allows us to set the mainboard you want to build the coreboot for. For example, we may choose, let's see, Tecly, F6, and as we can see, we have just selected a new mainboard. You can select some ROM size for it, let's say 8 megabytes. You can select some system power state after the power has failed. We can also provide some flash map description file, which I also described you in the previous lessons. So here you pass the path to the FMD file, which describes the regions and the sizes and stuff. Here we may define the size of CPU file system. This typically depends on the size of the BIOS region on Intel platforms. So here it will be, let's say, 6 megabytes. And let's move to the next category, which is chipset. Chipset contains mainly the SoC specific stuff, like the microarchitectural stuff. And here we can see we can enable some options like hyperthreading. These options like indicate whether the platform can have a replaceable CPU with Skylake CPU, Kaby Lake, dual core, or quad core. These options just indicate whether additional microcode files should be included. There's also some options like for the AME regions, for the read write updates of the AME, whether to perform MP initialization by FSP and stuff. There's also other options like we can enable SGX, the ACPI timer, legacy PET timer, and other stuff. Also, here we may set the main feature control register log bit and virtualization. Here we may also select which microcode file to include, whether we generate it from the available tree or include external binaries. We can also add some file descriptor if we have one, and an image. We can also apply a MIG cleaner if you want. We can also select which boot block to load, which other stage actually to load. Depending on the CMOS, or always we can load the fallback. The fallback means the prefix which is appended to the stage name in the CPFS. We can also protect some flash regions, like we can lock ME and ME TXC region, or use the preset values. So basically it says whether the IFD tool, which is available in coreboot, should log the flash descriptor which you provide here in the file. So next section is the devices section. And here we mainly have options for the graphics device and PCI Express devices. So basically, we select here which kind of operation we can perform to initialize the graphics. Like we can use the open source libgfx init library, which is written in Spark Ada language, or we can alternatively run for VGA optionals or run the GOP driver from FSP, or either do nothing. You can also set what the frame buffer should be like, whether we want to show the graphical book splash and stuff. Also, there is a new option which allows us to configure the PCI bus master bits in coreboot for the devices. You can also enable some PCI Express power management features like common clock, SPM, substates. We can also enable hot plug, and then we see how many buses we want to reserve and how much memory we want to reserve for these buses and stuff. We can also override the PCI subsystem, vendor device ID, and include VGA BIOS images. We can include VBT binary, we can add additional VGA image as well, if we have more than one graphics controller in the system. Generic drivers. Generic drivers describe the options that are available for the platform from the generic coreboot drivers, which are common across many platforms. We can enable some event log in the flash. We can enable some MID to data store, which is a data store in the spy flash, which uses SMI interrupts to communicate to this store. We can also enable some other additional modules like Oxford OXPCIe. We can add support for VPD. VPD is a structure defined by the Chrome OS project, which is used widely to store some vital configuration for the platforms, Chromebooks. We can include some serial numbers, CBFS, and other stuff. Here we also may configure how we should include the FSP binaries. We may either use the FSP repo or add in some external FSP binaries, which we provide the path to. And we can also enable the logo, which is a BMP file passed to the FSP to be displayed during the synchronization. May initialize the PS2 keyboard and other stuff as well. Some security. This is probably the most interesting menu. So it consists now of a few options here, like verified boot, in short vBoot. This is a library developed by the Chrome OS project for the sake of secure boot of the Chromebook devices. And it does the cryptographical verification of various firmware components. I won't go into much details because it's very, very complex menu and has a lot of various options, which most of them is not used on regular platforms that are not Chromebooks. We can also enable trusted platform module here, like for example, we have available option for TPM 2.0. We can enable measured boot and stuff. The memorization is quite simple because the only option right now here is the option to clear all free DRAM on regular boot. It is very useful for example, if we have some secrets in the memory, especially when we have, for example, the trusted execution technology, which enforces us to clear the memory if it detects any secrets may be leaked. And one may want it just for security. We have also added the TXT support menu, which allows us to include the ACMs in the image, enable verbose logging, and basically execute the TXT driver implemented in coreboot. We have also SMI transfer monitor integrated to coreboot. So you may select this option and basically provide the path to STM binary, which will be integrated and loaded into SMM. We have also the boot protection menu, which allows us to set the spy flash log bits, which are specific to given controller or spy flash chip. Console. It's basically a menu for various debugging options, like where the core boot console should be output, like from which stages, what kind of serial port to serial port or other consoles do you want to enable. Like we can have a speaker modem or a network console over compatible adapter, or we can have spy flash console output, which just writes to the spy flash the output of the commands, the output of the core boot logs. We can also configure the debug level. We can configure postcodes, which can be, for example, written to LPC interface for use with a debug postcard. System tables are practically a menu for generating some BIOS tables. Some platforms may also have PIRQ table or MP table for generation and other stuff. You basically can set here what the SMBIOS should be populated with. Payload. Another very important submenu, because here we may choose the final application, which is loaded by coreboot. And as I have previously described, we have various payloads to choose, like Tiano core payload, Linux, Linux boot, CBIOS, Yavits, UBoot, grep2, Philo, or any other executable payload. You can also have various other payload specific options here, like some CBIOS configuration. But if we choose, for example, the Tiano core, we will have Tiano core specific options, like which kind of Tiano core payload flavor we want, which target architecture or release debug build and stuff. Also, we may select to build a Pixie ROM. We can use IPXE open source implementation to build it, or we may add some secondary payloads, which I also described earlier, like core info mem test tint. And here we may even select the revision for the mem test. Okay, and the last one is the debugging menu, which allows us to enable even more messages to be displayed besides those which are printed by default in the core boot in the console menu, which is configured by the debug level in the console menu. And it allows us to output some verbose messages, like for example, we may have SMM debugging when we select this option. We can have some verbose CBFS debug messages. So whenever an access to CBFS is done, the console will print an additional debugging messages when, for example, scanning the CBFS for the requested file. You can also display more information about FSP, like here. You can also display firmware integrated version information from the FSP and stuff. For example, we may also configure the image for the DeepRock AM100 emulator, or for example, compile a debug code in ADA sources, which is especially useful for debugging the libgfx in it. And we have, for example, spyflash debug messages when we want to debug spyflash access through the chipset. Okay, I will leave a deeper investigation of these options to you. Just a quick reminder, you may use the slash button to search for a configuration parameter, or press the question mark to, for example, display the help of a given option to give you more overview and details what a given option really does when selected. Note that not all options may have some help, like let's see. for example, CPU MD Pi. And as you can see, this is an internal option which is selected by some given CPUs and microarchitectures. And this is basically are not meant to be selected by menu config. So they have no help section. Okay, so that would conclude the menu config. The menu config section. So please try it yourself, go through the menu and try to explore as much as you can to learn how it looks like.